This is Andrew Richardson and Andrew Coyne coming to you from Capital Strength Performance for MMA Mania to do another fighter-on-fighter technique highlight. So this time we're going to take a look at current light heavyweight kingpin, Daniel Cormier. Last time we did Daniel Cormier, we talked about his chain wrestling. It's a major technique. But in this time we're going to talk about more of a strategy than a specific move. It's Cormier's ability to blend his wrestling and level changes into striking. So this is probably the most effective way for a wrestler to land punches, because once you start playing with your opponent's perception of whether they're going to shoot or punch, it really just messes all their defenses up. Makes it a guessing game, and if they guess wrong, they get punched in the face or taken down. So a lot of times, Cormier is going to just throw some good punches, one, two, and then a shot. Standard stuff. Great wrestling. Let's say his opponent defends it. That's when Daniel's going to go back from low, back up high. So I'm going to throw that one, two, shot. Now his hands are low, I have to keep punching. Again, it's bringing his defense down and creating openings. Once I start doing that, I start landing off of clinches, the level change into the clinch, punch, and then shoot. So again, I'm just going up, down, up, down, up, down, and forcing my opponent to try to react to whichever. And off of that comes Cormier's uppercut a lot of times. So even just from distance, Cormier or level change or reach down to the leg, level change into an uppercut. That's how he knocked out Patrick Cummings. And on a similar note, if he throws those punches, it's a shot block that comes in to a clinch, collar tie, overhook, whatever. Again, Cormier's uppercuts and back into a level change into a takedown are all there. That constant game of going up and down is a really difficult strategy for anyone to deal with.